This is Ardwulf. Welcome. We are going to talk briefly about Wargame accessories. I may end up doing a future video on this, but I wanted to do a quick video on the stuff I have on hand to assist Wargaming and Wargaming play to go smoothly. And you may have already seen this guy that I did a video on the other day. This is the Organ Laminations 2mm Deluxe Corner Clipper. And I will get into the details of this and more details of this in a future video. I like it so far. Beyond that, that's all I'll say. There is some technique involved in using it that I wouldn't necessarily have foreseen prior to using it. So I'll have some more thoughts about this guy. For those of you who can see, I've still got some trimmings in there. We'll just brush those off and vacuum them up later. If you don't use this, you have two alternatives. One is to not clip your counters at all. I am a corner clipper. I like to clip corners. The traditional way to do that is with one of these nail clippers. And you can usually get these for like a buck or a buck 99 or something like this. This is just like a standard fingernail clipper that I use. There's not any less technique involved in using one of these than there is in using this. So don't let that scare you off. I've been using this for 30 years or something like that. Never occurred to me to clip corners on the counters. And then the first time I played a war game, which would have been ASL, with clipped corners, I have never gone back. But I like my corners tight. I like to clip off as little as possible, which is why I went for the 2mm version of this guy instead of the 2.5 or 3mm versions. Most counters these days are still probably half-inch counters or thereabouts, so I felt like 2mm was the best choice for me personally. Now, the other day, I was at the Container Store, and I've talked in the past about these plastic Container Store containers, and I've been looking around at the Container Store and at various craft stores looking for like a plastic box that I can contain like a general wargaming kit, specifically for ASL, but not just ASL. And I couldn't find anything that would fit everything that I wanted to fit, like tweezers and dice and pencils and stuff like that, that was still relatively compact. And when I was at the craft store, I said, you know, I got like a million of these cigar boxes that the local tobacconist just gives away, assuming you're a shopper there. Why don't I take a look at what I got and see if I can convert something there. So I got this out of the drawer. I'm not a huge cigar smoker, but I go in there occasionally, and they're happy to have me walk out with four or five cigar boxes. And then I took another cigar box and dismantled it, and took the little cedar plankings out of it, and I glued these into place, so everything is very secure. So what I got here is ideally something I can take to ASL stuff to play ASL with. So I got my, you know, small multicolored ASL dice in here, plus a few extra dice I threw in just for good measure in case I need a dice. I've got my Wargaming tweezers here. I've got this tin of plastic thing, I guess, not a tin, but of little markers that I can use to signify whatever on the Wargaming board. I think I just dropped a couple. I'd rather have little wooden blocks or something like that, but this is perfectly fine. These are scavenged out of an old Risk set that I don't have anything except the pieces left. This I use for judging line of sight in ASL, and it works pretty well for that. It's an old badge holder that fell apart, so I said, you know, I could still use this for ASL, so we did that. Eventually, when I find them, I'll put my OBA cards in this compartment. Then I got a couple pencils in here. I'll probably throw some more in here at some point. But I felt like this was a nice, elegant, and very nice-smelling little kit that I could carry with me to war games. So, on the subject of dice, it's always nice to have something that you can roll dice in. So, I made this guy. Now what this is like a picture box that I bought from the craft store. I just took the plastic out of the top and took the little clamps and stuff off the bottom and glued the back in and then lined it with self-adhesive felt. And it's not bad. Dice, I tend to get a fair amount of action on dice. Now it's not doing it, of course, but it's really easy to throw dice and have them roll out of this thing, I found. At least the way I throw dice. So I wasn't really happy with it. It's like I said, it's not bad, and I won't say I'll never use it. But what I ended up doing was, I think, a better solution. This is a dice tower. Now, I'm sure if you've been paying any attention at all, you've seen dice towers before. I made this one. It's made out of 3mm chipboard. Total cost on this and the two other ones that I made at the same time was probably less than $20 between some felt and some paint and some varnish that I put on it and the chipboard itself. And I just used Elmer's glue all to put this thing together and a craft knife. And it's a two-piece model, so you can break it down and you can set it back up. You can throw a dice in it, and it works fairly well. I made this specifically so it would accommodate one of these big D30s. And I'd like it to be a little heavier, I think, but with regular non-crazy person dice, it works pretty well. And I have yet to test roll it and have the dice pop out the front. So I was pretty happy with that. I have a vague plan to make another one of these for ASL specifically. If so, I may do a video like how to do one of these. I also bought these like little furniture non-skid bumper pads because this varnished bottom was sliding around on the tabletop. This way, it's much less susceptible to that. But I'm very happy with the way this turned out. And of course, I painted it in as close as the hobby store had to U.S. Army Green. I've also got for rolling dice this whiskey glass. It's the only whiskey glass I have that no whiskey has ever been poured in. But hey, if you after the game, there's nothing to prevent you from doing so. And it works fairly well. And I've rolled these dice in this particular glass on video before. If you've checked out my video of the Hunters, the U-Boat Solitaire game. And this works pretty well. And the nice thing about it is it's got a real small footprint. So you can just throw your dice in, boom. Some people keep their hand over to keep dice from bouncing out. But I find that unless you're like throwing them in there, that's not really a problem. Now, I've also done a whole series of videos on counter trays and stuff like that. So I'm not going to talk about how to store war games in this video. But I will mention this. This is just like a bell jar, a ball jar. That's an off-brand ball jar that I use to store all those blank counters in that I get in various war games. And we may be able to like salvage some of these for replacement purposes if I have to ever replace any counters. That's not a ton of them, but I think half of these are probably from Avalon, a couple Avalon Hill games that I punched in the last 6 months. But it's pretty handy. I've seen some people save their corner clippings actually in a big jar like this. I'm not doing that at this time. That's a little too OCD even for me. So I hope this has been helpful. Like I said, I might do some future videos on how to build some of this stuff that I made. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.